Let's see, where do I start this? Okay. I could start this, I guess, at the beginning. Okay. Yesterday, I think I was, I spoke to this guy I speak to every week now. And I posed a question to him about Al Pacino's head, and it got into another realm. First of all, maybe you guys will notice the difference. Al Pacino in The Godfather, as opposed to Al Pacino in The Devil's Advocate, do you notice a head change? Do you notice his head got smaller and his teeth got bigger? Well, anyway, this guy says, it looked like his face melted. I just think his teeth got bigger and his head got smaller, but anyway, that's beside the point. Well, after I posed that question, mind you, this guy is a graduate with his degree in fine arts and ran around pantsless, which proves he's got confidence and he's probably crazy. Actually, he is crazy because he said so. People with fine arts degrees, he said, are crazy. I believe him. He told me two interesting stories. One was about the selling of dehydrated H2O and the red paperclip. In the dehydrated H2O, somebody sold it and all the people had to do was add water. Now, I haven't done any research to find out if these things are accurate, but these are interesting concepts. If you can make money selling H2O and rehydrating it by adding water, H2O is water, so you're just buying nothing. In regard to the red paperclip, it's a matter of trading up a red paperclip to a house. Let's say I have a pen, I go on the internet and say, hey, I've got a pen. Who would like to trade me up for it? And you have a book that I want. Well, I'd get your book, you'd get my pen, I'd take your book and get something else that I'd want in somebody else's repertoire. What he had told me from the red paper clip, the guy got a house that he was able to keep for a year. Again, I have not researched this to verify the information. However, these are interesting concepts. I came up with a concept myself, and that is for hubris. Jar, bag, bottle, whatever, hubris, and sell it. It could exist as a bottle of air. You can't see the air, but it's definitely in there. Or you could put glitter of the person's choice of color. If the person is cheap, they don't even have to sprinkle the magic confidence dust on themselves. What they can do is just go like this. I am confident. I am confident with their little empty jar. The instructions would read, you must believe in the product in order for it to work. Therefore, it's not actually a lie. It's not a lie at all. In order to create your confidence or build it with the magic powder, you have to believe it exists, just like people believe that God exists. He's not out there, he's in you, because you are God, you are the creator of God. Man created God, God didn't create man. Same thing happens here. You want to create confidence and you believe it's magic, it comes from within, bring it out. The same could be said if you buy my invisible mask, you wear it, it'll hide your face and you can be who you want to be, the person behind the skin who's afraid to show their face for fear of reprisal or what have you, fear of what other people think. And a lot of people are held back by what other people think. Really, no one should give a rat's ass what other people think. Although it's interesting that a lot of people worry about what other people are saying about them. I always say, worry when they stop talking. Anyway, getting back to my sale of hubris in a bottle, jar, or bag. If I didn't mention bag, that should be included. Color of the dust, sand, air. Well, you can't color the air. Well, you can. If it's, well, it wouldn't be air, it'd be gas, colored gas. Sand could be colored also. It could be kept or sprinkled. However you want to manufacture your hubris or invisible mask. What do you think the potential is for people to gain gonads? It's just an idea. I just feel that I think with a bit more confidence, people will be able to get out there and be more real. Anyway, that's my thought for the day. Maybe my thought for the week, maybe my thought for life, because I'll drop dead tonight of a heart attack. Who the fuck knows? Anyway, putting it out here, keeping it real. Let me know what you think. Later.